Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. It's been over a month since I've done my build update, so here's a video to share my progress so far. Currently now I'm at 3.56 million health and about 1.1k vit. So I managed to enchant most of my stats to vit and then I just left it there. So I think I only have one line of dex here, the rest is everything all changed to vit. Here I also bought one gold eclipse ring. So I was actually saving up for a gold talisman, but this ring it was on the exchange for quite cheap and I just managed to buy it at quite a discount. So now I'm back to saving up diamonds for a gold talisman. The cards I also have swapped out, so now I'm using a stun resist card on one, so this one I also managed to buy quite cheap before the price increased. I'm running one marine sphere now, so after so many weeks of endless tower, I managed to exchange one marine sphere because using the ET mats to exchange for marine sphere is actually cheaper than buying off the exchange center. So the trend here is I'm trying to swap out all my Vitata cards because is getting quite irritating, especially in ET with the increased SP cost. Tech speed talisman now, I'm still running Vitata, but I'm considering whether I should just remove it and run like a white card or something instead of the Vitata card. So I do lose my 18% pen from the three Vitata cards, but I think overall it's still worth it just because it is easier to play like this. I also swapped out to Valkyrie set already, I lost my 6 set blue, so I no longer have the effect of payback, which is my only source of reflect. So now I prioritize farming Sage Worm cards to get some physical reflect. Managed to get the shoes and the cloak to +4 and the armor is +2 since it only just gives defense, so it's still alright. My upgrade awakening now is at level 4, tier 4, which is the weapons at 120, armor at 60, and accessories at level 30. And while enchanting out all my stats, I managed to get my enchanting to level 3 on enchant and upgrade tier 4, enchant tier 3. Now let's check out my DPS for attack speed build, then I'll move over to the haste build to just compare the DPS. So here I'm using the Battle Wheel trick I shared in an earlier video, so I just get it up to 8 stacks, turn on self-ignite, and then count my DPS from there. Okay, 1 minute is up, and as you can see, my damage here is 525k, about 526k here for my attack speed build. So let's move on to my haste build and check it out. I'm on my haste build now, and let's see what my DPS is after 1 minute. Okay, 1 minute is up, so you can see my damage here for 1 minute is about 563k DPS. So you may have noticed that my haste build actually overtook the attack speed build. So previously, it was the other way around. The attack speed actually did more DPS than the haste build. So I attribute that to auto counter and self ignite. So auto counter is a very strong skill that deals a damage based on the percent of your HP. So as your HP increases, the damage of auto counter will overtake that of attack speed. So currently now, I only have enough haste for level 7 auto counter, which is near to zero variable cooldown.
And with more haste, I can add more levels and I'll get more percent of my HP. So currently, I only do 6.8% of my max HP. That concludes my video for today. If you'd like to stay up to date with my build, please remember to subscribe and also share with your friends if you found this useful. Thank you to Alonis for pointing out that I don't plug my channel enough. And as usual, you can ask me any questions in the comment below. And I'll see you guys in the next video.